It's my daughter Hope's birthday today. We're meeting her for a walk and a picnic. And just noticed it's raining there in the window. And I thought I'd just make her a card. Hope made me this paper for Christmas. So I'm going to use some of that to make her a card. And I thought I may as well record it because I've not done a video for a few days now, you'll be noticed. This is the picture I think I last showed you on the YouTube video. And that was what inspired me to do something for a card for Hope. Okay, right, see you in a minute. Get these sorted and then hopefully that'll be static for the duration and that I won't be in your way. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, I'm maybe just gonna start. I might do something similar to that sleeping fairy. just use my non-dominant hand. I didn't put the microphone on because I thought I'd be close enough to you there, but I'm starting to whisper again, aren't I? I was saying I'll just use my non-dominant hand there. So I'm right-handed, so I'm just using my left hand because I like the mark that my left hand makes and I like how it slows me down. So I'm just using a black felt pen to draw out this image. Hope is a bit of a tree lover, nature lover, and has been missing her time in nature recently. So hopefully this is something that she'll like, this image. And she has this beautiful long wistful hair as well, so I'm gonna put some of that. I thought I would use my left hand after I turned on the video, because the reason I put you over there was because I thought I'd be using my right hand and that you'd be able to see what I was doing, but now I'm covering it. So, sorry about that. And Maisie is, she's doing a bit of, what's it called? Tree? Not sculpting. You know the guys who, anyway, she's taking branches off the Christmas tree. And she seems to be okay. There's just one that she kind of chews on, so I don't think it's going to do her any damage. It's just the barky bit. So all kind of rounded. Yeah, I want to kind of get a feel for the soft edges of nature really here. Okay. All right, and I think I'll just bring some colour in and start using my other hand, mostly so you can see what I'm doing as well, but also I feel like the drawing is the part that I wanted to kind of do a little bit more organically. And now I can do the colouring in that fun bit as well. Okay. Alright, so maybe start with some gold. So this is gold chalk, uni chalk pen. Oh, that's quite a lot of gold came out there. That's nice. Yeah, so my plan had been to do videos every day, you know, I say that, and you know, as insofar as I can, I will. My goodness, there's lots of gold just kind of pours out every so often. It's quite nice having a surrounding of gold, I think. Okay. And it's soaking nicely into this beautiful handmade paper. Guys, I'm doing a video, okay? I was just saying I'm doing a video. Just a few minutes. And you probably won't even come down before it's up, but just in case. So I love all these kind of oranges, reds and browns for this kind of homage to nature. This was an image that came, I think I told you that the other day, if you had a look at one of my other videos, I was talking about having, during an online dance kind of class that I did on New Year's Day, this kind of image came to me of being really restful in nature and just lying and covered in leaves, really, inside in a dugout, little hole in the ground. The earth. And so that image came to me when I was dancing, and I drew it afterwards, and then it just brings me back to the feeling of that kind of restful state when I draw this image. So that's it. And I'm enjoying Hope's paper. It's great. What this gold is like now, it's a different type of acrylic pen, slightly darker gold. It's filling some of the space. I think it's time for me to get some new pens again. You know what, Lily started doing some writing and things, I'd forgotten that. And she's taken the sparkly gel pens out of here, so I need to retrieve those from her bedroom. So smaller gel pens that came to a fine point. Quite nice for doing little details and things. And this is a copper Sharpie. It's more like brown really here, but that works. It's the cocooning kind of feel that I really love about this image. The feeling of being held. and peace and just permission to fully rest. He's having a good drink of water there. This is one of the silver gel pens. It's actually not, I don't think it has much of an impact, does it? Well, kind of. Over the acrylic. Depends on what's underneath it. Here's a different coloured shark, you know, although it actually looks pretty much the same as the last one. Putting some red in. Oh, I'm liking that red. It's a it's a deep... Sorry, you're probably not able to hear me at all, because I'm being so quiet. But I was just saying there, I'm liking this red. It's a deep, rich red. Looks like it's kind of a rooted, if you could do a little rooted thing into the earth there. Like a tree growing up, firmly established roots in Mother Earth. So I was remembering there, you know, 24 years ago, yesterday, Hope was born, and she was born at home, and we had a house at the time that overlooked Arthur's seat, and as it happens, that's where we're going today now to meet for our picnic. But I remember during labour with Hope, walking over and back and over and back for hours and hours, like in labour, and having the vision of Arthur's seat. It was during the middle of the night, so there was this beautiful silhouette of Arthur's seat visible through the window, and it was just me, and because things hadn't really hotted up yet, you know, so Gordon was still asleep and the midwife hadn't come, and I was walking for hours on my own, and it's a very rich memory for me, that beautiful kind of quiet time of deep expectancy as well, like in kind of a sense of entering an adventure of the unknown, I thought it was unknown. But everything went smoothly, you know. And she was born in the morning at 8 o'clock. Let's see. Yeah, I seem to keep going with the orange theme here. So that was 24 years ago, but you know, I remember it very clearly. I remember the feeling at least. He's playing with the Christmas tree decorations, as you can probably hear. Yeah? What? Yeah? some more red in here. The red into the gold there, so I'm not sure if it's going to stay working for much longer. This is a nice rich brown colour. I'm going to be back with my floral paintings on the easel in the next few days. I've got a few more to do for folks, so that'll be my project for the next few days again. I look forward to that. I love painting flowers, really. Some little silver shapes here. The soup and the cooker. And I'm gonna just bought a second flask, so we've got enough for everybody. I'm gonna fill the soup. And we've got a lemon drizzle cake and candles, but it's unlikely the candles will stay lighting, is it? In this weather, we need to find somewhere sheltered. Boot of the car to sit the cake in. I had an idea there, it's going to do something. I forget what it was. Oh, yeah, it was part of that vision involved daisies. I wonder if this will work. No. Doesn't really stay very white on top of the other colours, I don't think. It soaks in, doesn't it? That's it's a bit whiter there. Probably could make some little daisies. Or if not, at least some kind of snowdrops. I like the contrast of the white, but actually the silver contrast is quite nice, isn't it? Okay. Maybe this will be stronger. Not really. I'm thinking to leave her skin just like that, except that I might put some gold on the eyelids. And maybe the lower lip as well. Nancy's trying to push her way right under my chair. See, it's almost time for us to go now, you know. It might look a bit weird, will it? Yeah, a little bit. Just tone it down a little. open the brown again. This one would be left. Maisie's coming with us, by the way. She's going to get a good walk. There's just a bit of a pool of that came out there. I quite like it with the oranges, though. What's this one like? That's quite dark. So we've made leek and potato soup. That's what we're gonna have. Sorry, it's maybe going a bit crazy. Leek and potato soup and lemon drizzle cake. And we will be heading off fairly soon now. So we better not do anything too... Well, that's okay. These pens are good because generally you can go back in if you do something and you're not happy with it. I can find something that will cover it. Actually, it did seem to make the face of it just smaller around the jaw with that blue. So I wonder now if this white will have any impact over that to soften that outside edge again. Yeah, it's gonna leave that. It's giving her a slightly avatar look, which mightn't be any harm. But I suppose if she's an avatar in the bottom half of her face, she'll need to be an avatar at the top half as well. Is that one I used? No. I don't know where the blue is that I used. This one. Yeah. Oh, Maisie. Those bulbs are dangerous when she cracks them. Slight bluish glow to the hands as well then. Hope's hair used to be blue. It used to be that colour blue. Beautiful. Thank you. interesting film thing going on here with the films.
When are we meant to leave?
Where is he? Leave around 5 to 1. What time is it now, Aine? Okay, I better stop with this now because I'm going to do the fill the flask with soup. Oh, big blob of white came out there. Okay. Right, I'm gonna stop there.
It's okay. What did she eat this quarter? She's got quarter.
She just broke one of those one of the balls from the Christmas tree baubles.
I know. You see.
She got a glittery beard.
She's got quarter over and see her corner, isn't it?
Trigger happy with these pens. Okay, that's out there. There it is. Thanks for watching. And make sure. Okay, see you tomorrow. Bye.